What's going on, guys? It's Ron from the Green Mountain Rangers. We're gonna do another video that we've been getting a lot of questions about and just a lot of interest in. We're gonna do a video talking about our Crye JPC and some of the slight modifications that we do that makes it just a little bit, you know, more unique in the way that you need something to be. So again, when you watch this video, I really want you to focus on what this is able to do for you, not just what it is, and you know, hopefully you'll take a little bit more of the why instead of the what. So as you see it, this is the JPC in the styling kind of setup that I've personally been running. Some of the other guys have seen it, liked it, and they're getting them too, and we're setting them up this way. Overall, I could say the JPC solves the same problem that we had using the 6094A in the past. It's very similar styling. It's a very minimalist plate carrier that has the kangaroo insert built in. I kind of like the kangaroo as part of the vest because I know that we're going to use our Kydex insert in the vest, because for us it's just the lowest platform for holding three magazines. And if it didn't have the Kydex, if it didn't have the kangaroo insert stitched into the vest, it's just another layer of pouches that you're going to have to add onto a platform. Where I like it, you know, I know that I'm going to do it anyway, I'd rather just have it already built in so it's just less material and less bulk. When you look at the JPC, they went in a kind of a little bit more of a different style direction as far as the way that the angles of the shoulder pads and the way that they built them. I kind of like these, I feel like this is looks like Hyperlon to me, or you know, some really nice non-slip padded nylon that, you know, is very nice because it's the only strap that I found so far that it feels like nothing. Where the 6094A with the woven Cordura and the stitch and then the Eagle shoulder pads that we used to use, when you shouldered the gun, you definitely felt the strap there a little bit more. With the JPC, you don't feel anything. It's pretty much just two plate bags with, you know, very simple but very, very comfortable, light straps. This vest, I feel, is definitely more of a hugger feel. The vest feels like it becomes part of you, instead of where the 6094A, I felt the vest was hanging on you. It really wasn't a cohesive part of you. You'd still get a little side-to-side movement. With the JPC, you get none of that. Maybe it's lighter. We'll get into some of the material or how we set the cummerbund on this one compared to the 6094A. But it's a really nice vest. I really like it. And maybe you can get some insight to why maybe you want to pick one up. All right, so we did three modifications to the vest that just gives us a little bit more capability. We added a little piece of Velcro to the top of the shoulder pad so we can put our V lights up there. We made a GMR Gear Kydex insert that holds three mags that fits right in the JPC's kangaroo. It's really nice. It's the most low profile, minimalist piece of equipment that we could add to the vest that perfectly holds three mags, totally secure. Then we also added the pig elastic cummerbund to the JPC, replacing the Crye air light system. Very comfortable. We'll get into it, talk about it a little bit more, but these are the modifications that we did to the JPC. So this is the stock JPC as you would get it when you order from Crye. You can see this is their air light system. It's a skeletonized moly strap system that is held together with some shock cord, bungee cord in the back of the vest. The only problem that I felt that when I got this vest and when I put it on is that the tension for the strap system was not uniform. Since it's only pulling from the back and there's no give in any of the moly strap, I felt when I breathed in or when I moved in different directions that it was too tight and there was not enough play in the vest. Something that I became very used to wearing the 6094A with the elastic cummerbund. So all I did was the same concept that we had for the 6094A. I wanted to add a side low profile elastic system to this vest to give it more comfort, more mobility, more agility. So we'll show you how we did that. All right, so if you want to do the JPC Cummerbund mod, the first thing you're going to have to do is, when you get your Crye vest, just take it apart. You want to have the back panel independent from the rest of the vest, because that's where all the magic's going to happen. So you can undo this air light system and just kind of strip that off the vest. Undo the Velcro, take the shoulder pads off so that the back carrier is free. All right, so now that you have your JPC back panel independent, the next thing you want to do is just take it and flip it inside out. So I'm going to show you the seams that you're going to open up. The nice thing about this mod is that it's not that involved. So even if you don't have a sewing machine or know someone who does, we're going to show you how you can just set this up and take it to any tailor that's at any cleaners. Most, you know, it'll charge you a couple bucks, but they'll do a really nice job, and then you'll have the modification for your vest. Okay, so now that you have your JPC flipped inside out, what you're essentially gonna have to do is you're gonna have to open the two main body seams so that you can slip the elastic cummerbund in there and have it restitched. So the sizing that you're going to use is the elastic cummerbund is pretty much perfectly in line with the first and third Molly Rose. So you're gonna, you can really just take a, you know, a chalk pen or whatever, a marker, and just, this is the distance that you're gonna need to open this seam. Doing it this way is nice because you don't have to open the main support at the bottom of the vest. So you're really just opening a small portion that will be very easily restitched. So you can do that with a, you know, an X-Acto knife, a bunch of different tools, but using one of these seam rippers that you can get at any arts and crafts store, you know, makes it go really, really fast and very precise. So you're gonna open the outer seam, then you can just kind of pull on these threads, and then you're gonna also need to open this inner seam. Just go slowly, and you know, it will open up. Just kind of pull on these threads a little bit, and then you can use a seam ripper or you know, any straight edge, and just drop it down there and just open this body up. All right, so now that you have both sides of your back panel opened up, the main seam, again, it should be sized in between the first and third row of the Molly tacking. So now that you have your elastic cummerbund, you can use either side. I personally find that the side that I want to use as the closure on the vest is the smaller, thinner side. Since it's less bulk, it's still, you know, you get all the stability out of it, and it's just lower profile compared to the one that they want you to use. It has, it's just a thicker package. It has, you know, these paracord pulls that I guess are nice, you know, to use. I like running the smaller side, just lower profile. So now what I would do is I'm going to cut the elastic cummerbund apart so that I just have the elastic and the Velcro closure free-floating. When you cut across this seam, you're going to be cutting essentially the elastic from the pad and Velcro sleeve that sits over the elastic. And you can pull that off. So now what you're going to have is just a freestanding 4-inch piece of elastic and the Velcro closure. This is going to be one of your side straps. So cut the other so you have them. So now that you slip, you flip your back panel right side out, what you can do now is you're going to find the sizing that you're going to use for your strap. But you can fit these in through the opening in the seam that you have, just so you can see what the vest is going to look like. All you're going to have to do now is put both straps on the sides, pull them through, and then pretty much all you're going to have to do is just kind of size it. You're going to hold the this back panel open on your body, and then just kind of
fit the strap around to see how much distance you need out of this strap. Generally, I found tighter is probably better, especially in the elastic. And you know, if you have a little bit more, it's not perfect. It doesn't matter because it's elastic. Okay. Now that you have both straps fit into the vest, you can stick a pin through there. So when you flip the vest inside out again, it doesn't come out. Or at this step now, you could take this to any tailor you know, any cleaner. Someone has, usually they have someone that can do alterations for you. So what you're gonna do now is you can flip the vest inside out. And after you've sized it, just take a chalk pen or something. You can mark on the strap the distance inside the vest that you know that the strap needs to go. So you can fold these straps on the inside of your vest, let them kind of lay flat. Now, essentially, this is what you have, what's gonna look like if you're gonna be doing the stitching yourself or you're taking it to someone. That you have the correct sizing. Generally, it'll probably be the same on either side so that when you put the vest on, it's not out of whack when you're tightening it down. So pretty much what you could do is you could take this to any tailor, have them stitch that for you, or you can do it yourself. So at this stage, with the proper sizing, you can pin it in place and you're gonna stitch back up these two main seams on the sides of the body. Okay, so now I permanent marked the sew line for the correctly sized elastic cummerbund. The Crye Airlight, this is like the single strap attachment point. You're not gonna need this anymore and it's kinda gets in the way when you're sewing, so I just cut this off right away. It makes the vest look cleaner on the back without it anyway. So I personally don't need it. You can sew around it. I choose not to. You're gonna do that on both sides. There's one on either side. I don't need them anymore. So I just lose them. All right, so now that you have the seam open, correctly sized cummerbund, just put it in place and now you can stitch it. All right, so all you do now is you stitch the seams closed. You can follow the provided seams, and then you can just go back and forth and reinforce it. You make several passes in the seam line, and then you can do a box stitch or a zigzag stitch to kind of hold that fabric in place a little bit more. So now that you've stitched both sides of the cummerbund to the back of the JPC, you can just cut off the excess. Now your vest is pretty much assembled. Flip it back, right side out. Now you should have the assembled back panel with your elastic cummerbund nicely attached to the back of your vest. Super clean, very minimalist, very comfortable. So if you want to add your little bit of Velcro for your V-light, for your shoulder strap as well, all you gotta do is just cut out little piece of Velcro. I kind of do it in the shape of the V-light so it looks a little bit nice and clean. Then just take some simple pins and just pin it in place. Again, if you're not going to be doing the stitching yourself, just get everything done, all the prep work, so when you take it to someone, it's a no-brainer. There's no questions about how it's got to be. You tell the guy, this is what it's got to do. He'll do it up for you real nice. Or you can even start opening the seam this way. It doesn't really matter how you want to do it, but event, you just got to open this seam. Not that big of a deal. Seam ripper looks a good look right now because it just got a very nice tip that will just get inside the sew line, and then you can just use the edge that will open that up for you. Cool, so now that you have your V-Lite Velcro pinned in place, all you gotta do is stitch it and then flip it inside out and reclose the seam. Okay, now that you have your Velcro on there, perfectly sized so that the V-Lite almost just kind of floats on your shoulder pad, really nice. All you're gonna do, fold it back over, put your hydration tubes or cable ties, I kind of like to lay them flat, and then you're just going to reclose the stitch. You can put a pin in it if you want, if you find that easier, or you know, just whoever's going to do it for you, the tailor, just have it prepped and ready so that they can do it without any questions. Yeah, so pretty much you did all the legwork. You got your cummerbund on, you got your V-Lite, and now you just put it back together. All right guys, so now that you've seen the video on the JPC modification, I hope you get a little more insight onto why we set it up in this manner. And we look at the vest as a platform. It's something that you can build up to your own specifications. This is just how we set it up. Your needs may be different, so you may have a different outcome than us. So look at the vest on what it can do for you and how you can build it to suit what you need it to do.
Yeah, the vest just isn't something that looks cool. It allows you to think more about the game rather than about your gear while playing.